Whenever you will find deliverance, wherever you will find healing, wherever you find a move of God, it is always associated with a sound. I want us to take just maybe 30 seconds and we're gonna sing this song. We're gonna raise it as an offering to the Lord. But I want us to take about maybe just 30 seconds, if you will. Brother, I just want you to minister on that guitar. I want you to raise your hands in his presence and let's just worship God all over this room. Come on, everybody, let's worship God all over this room. Hallelujah.
It all for me.
Listen, I want you to lift your hands for just a moment. Let's worship God. I want to hear that guitar for just a moment. I just want you to minister. The Bible calls it a Zamar praise. That praise upon the string instruments is that Zamar praise. Glory to God. The Bible says that Saul called for David to offer a Zamar praise. When he was troubled with the spirit, there are some of you who are troubled in your spirit. But as we worship God in this fashion, God is going to set you free in your spirit.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Let's just continue to celebrate. Even as the worship song was going, death could not hold you down. Hallelujah. You are the risen King. You're seated in majesty. You are the risen King. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I was sitting here reflecting, how does it feel to be on the risen King side? How does it feel to be on the side of the one who overcame death, who overcame death, who overcame every adversity, who overcame the grave? Hallelujah. It feels outstanding. Hallelujah. Because he created us in our image. So therefore we overcome as well. We're greater than conquerors. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We're victorious. Hallelujah. I celebrate this morning. I'm thankful this morning. We welcome you, oh God. Hallelujah. Welcome to KDMI. Welcome KDMI family. Hallelujah. Happy Sunday. Hallelujah. Welcome to our visitors who are viewing us live on Facebook and YouTube. Welcome to those who will be on the rewatch. Hallelujah. We thank you. We thank God for you all. And we're just grateful this morning. We're grateful for life. Hallelujah. We're grateful for breath in our bodies. Hallelujah. We're grateful, oh God, that he woke us up sane. Hallelujah. We're grateful, oh God, that we're not succumbing, oh God, to the pressures that we're all under. We're grateful, oh God, for you, Father. Hallelujah. We thank God. Hallelujah. That you overcame. Hallelujah. 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 And that you call us your own. Hallelujah, God. We praise God for our Father. Hallelujah. And we thank God for each and every one of you. Hallelujah. We're going to go ahead and get started. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So I'm going to ask, hallelujah, Minister Valerie Brooks to pray. And then immediately after that, Minister Beverly Grace will be singing, leading us in praise and worship this morning. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Okay. Hallelujah this morning. Good morning. I'm going to start with Lamentation 3 and 21. This I recall to my mind, therefore have I hope. It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed, because his compassion faileth not. They are new every morning. Great is thy faithfulness. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We enter to your gates right now, Lord God, with thanksgiving, Lord God. Just thanking you right now for today, Lord God. Thank you, Lord God, for new mercy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for new grace. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God, for you being God all by yourself. Thank you, Lord God, for you sits up high, Lord God. You look low, Father God. We bless you, Lord God. We welcome you on the line this morning, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. I just bless you right now, Lord God, because you are a good Father, Father God. You is awesome, Lord God. Hallelujah. You have kept us, Lord God, this week, Father God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Father God. I thank you right now, Lord God, for keeping us, Lord God, from things danger seen and unseen, Lord God. We are so grateful, Lord God, to be here on today, Father God, just to say thank you, Lord God, just to say hallelujah, Lord God, just to lift you up, Lord God. We know, Lord God, that when we come giving praise, Lord God, when we come, Lord God, into your presence, Lord God, when we worship you, Lord God, when we lay down, Lord God, every weight, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We know, Lord God, that you are more than able to do exceedingly and abundantly and above all that we can even ask. Hallelujah. Father God, we ask you right now, Lord God, to forgive us, Lord God, for anything, Lord God, that we may have said, we may have done, Lord God, anything that would keep us, Lord God, from entering to the holies of holies this morning, Father God. We ask right now, Lord God, that you will forgive us, Father God. Hallelujah. Against those things seen and unseen, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. I ask, Lord God, that you will touch hearts this morning, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that hearts will be open, Lord God, to receive, Lord God, what you have for us on today, Lord God. Father God, we wait in anticipation, Lord God, to hear what you have to say to your children on today, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. We bless you, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We are reminded, Lord God, you can do all things, Lord God. You can do all things but fail, Father God. So, Father God, whatever, Lord God, that your people are in need of on today, Lord God, you're more than able, Lord God, to move the stumbling blocks, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We know if we lift you up, we know if we clap our hands, we know if we stomp our feet, we know if we get into the presence of you, Lord God, you are more than able, Lord God, to do what you want to do on this line. Father God, I thank you, Lord God, for us coming together. I thank you, Lord God, that there was no bad news. Lord God, no one in KDMI lost a family member this week, Lord God. I thank you, Lord God, we are able to come together in unity. I thank you for us coming together in oneness. I thank you for the Bible studies this week, Lord God. I thank you for the prayers that went up this week, Father God. Father God, I pray right now, Lord God, whatever your people believe in you for, Lord God. Father God, I pray, Lord God, if it be your will, Lord God, hallelujah, that it shall come to pass. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. I bless you on today. Today is a good day, Father God. Hallelujah. To give you some glory. Hallelujah. Today is a good day, Lord God, to give you some praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. No matter how bad things may look around us, Lord God, hallelujah, let us not be consumed, Lord God, with the things of this world, Lord God, for we are not of this world, Lord God. Hallelujah. We're just pilgrims passing through. Hallelujah. Let us be reminded, Lord God, to cast our cares unto you on today, Lord God. Hallelujah. Whatever the need is, Lord God, Father God, you know what it is, that each and every last one of us need on today, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. It is nothing that we can come to you, Lord God, that you would keep from your children, Lord God. I pray for healing today. I pray for deliverance today. I pray that somebody, Lord God, will hear a word on today, Lord God. Hallelujah. They will be lifted up on today. Hallelujah, Lord God. Bless the people, Lord God. Bless our families, Lord God. Bless our marriages, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God. Let us forget those things of yesterday, Lord God, for today is a new day. Hallelujah, Lord God. We are reminded in your words, Lord God, that you give us new mercy, new grace every day, Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. We know, Lord God, that there's no guilt and shame in you, Lord God. All we got to do, Lord God, is repent, Lord God, of our ways, Lord God. Hallelujah, Father God, and you are more than able to forgive us, Lord God. So, Lord God, let us not look on yesterday, but let us press for the higher mark in you, Father God. Hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's praise him today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He's the one that holds us in his palm of his hands. Hallelujah. You is the one is more than able, Lord God, to change a situation in a twinkle of an eye, Lord God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So this is why we praise you on today. This is why we magnify you on today. This is why we lift you up on today, because we know when praises go up, hallelujah, blessings come down. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm glad that we're on a winning team today. I'm glad, hallelujah, that we woke up on this side of heaven on today just to say thank you one more time. Hallelujah. Just to glorify you one more time. Just to come together, Lord God, in unity and oneness and love, Lord God. Hallelujah. We pray, Lord God, that you will equip us, Lord God, for what it is that we may need, Lord God, to take us into next week, Lord God. We pray, Father God, for peace, Lord God. We pray right now, Lord God, that as you continue to build us up, Lord God, hallelujah, Lord God, let us be built on a sure foundation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You is the sure foundation, Lord God. Hallelujah. I pray for the word today. Hallelujah. I pray that the word, Lord God, would be a word that we can eat off, Lord God. We can feast off, Lord God, all week, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. However you want to do it on today, Lord God, let your will be done, Lord God. Hallelujah. Let hearts receive what it is that you have to say on today, Lord God. Hallelujah, Lord God. We give you those stony hearts, Lord God, and we pray, Lord God, for a flesh heart, Lord God, a heart that will be open to receive what it is that you have for us today, Lord God. For nothing is wasted, Lord God. Nothing that you do, Lord God, is wasted, Lord God. So I bless, Lord God, the speaker on today, Lord God. I pray, Lord God, that she would be decreased, Lord God, that you may be increased in her, Lord God. Let us say all that you have for her to say on today, Father God. Let not one word fall to the ground, Lord God, but hallelujah, Father God. Let us, Father God, eat of the word on today. I just thank you, Lord. I just bless you, Lord. I give you glory, Lord. I give you honor, Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, Lord God. Hallelujah. Touch each and every family on this phone today, Lord God. Touch us, Lord God, in a mighty way, Lord God. For those ones, Lord God, who may be feeling depressed, who may be feeling like giving up, who may be feeling like things ain't gonna never change. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I come to encourage you today. Hold on to God's unchanging hand. Hold on, hallelujah, to his words, hallelujah. For he said he stands over his words. He watches his words, hallelujah. His words will not fall to the ground. So whatever you believe in God for on today, hallelujah, I dare you to get up today, hallelujah. Watch your faith, hallelujah. Do what you got to do, but just believe it that God is more than able, hallelujah, to change any situation. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. I come to encourage somebody today who may be feeling, hallelujah, that this ain't for me. The devil is a lie. It is for you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Today was ordained for you to be on the line, for you to hear a word. Hallelujah, you just a word away. Hallelujah, don't give up now. Don't give out now. Hallelujah, but press forward. Press forward to the higher mark. Hallelujah, forget those things that are behind you. Hallelujah, let us press forward in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah, I dare you to get excited. I dare you to get excited. I dare you to give God a high praise. I dare you to clap your hands. I dare you to stomp your feet. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Do it until you feel, hallelujah, the glory of God fall down on you. Hallelujah. Praise your way out. Hallelujah. Praise your way out. Hallelujah. Whatever your situation is, praise your way out. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I bless you, Lord. Oh, God, I give you glory. Hallelujah. 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 If you can't think of a reason to say hallelujah for yourself, think about your neighbors. Think about your children. Think about your job. Hallelujah. And let that hallelujah go to another hallelujah. And hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I promise something's going to happen for you today. Hallelujah. Oh, glory to your name, Lord. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Hallelujah, we are victorious today. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We are above and not beneath. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to your name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Let us be mindful today, y'all, to lift up the name Jesus. Hallelujah, there's power in the name Jesus. Hallelujah, there's power in the name Jesus. Let us be reminded of the name Jesus. Hallelujah, just say the name Jesus. And I promise the more you say the name Jesus, something's going to happen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I bless the name Jesus. I thank you, Jesus, for when you got up, hallelujah, on the third day, hallelujah, hallelujah. I thank you, Jesus. I give you glory, Jesus. I give you the honor, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, hallelujah. Oh, glory, hallelujah. Oh, glory, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I just feel something in my belly, y'all, hallelujah. The more I say hallelujah, the more I feel something turning in my belly today, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. I just feel like praising you, Lord. I just feel like giving you the glory. Hey, y'all, mama, thank you, all about here. Oh, Yerabasia. Oh, Yerabasia. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, I bless the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. When all else fails, hallelujah. Just know that you got a friend named Jesus. Hallelujah. Who is in touch with your infirmities. Hallelujah. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, glory. I just feel like having church, y'all. Hallelujah. Oh, Yamama, thank you, Olomasia. Oh, Yamamasia. Oh, thank you, Jesus, for today, Lord God. I bless you, Lord, and I give you glory. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Glory to you, God. We welcome you here, Father God, and we're in your presence, Lord God, and we seek you day after day, God. Hallelujah. The more I seek you, the more I find you. The more I find you, the more I love you. I want to sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe and feel your heartbeat. This love is too deep. It's more than I can stand. I'm melting, your peace is overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe and feel your heartbeat. This love is too deep. It's more than I can stand. I'm melting, your peace, it's overwhelming me. The more I seek you, hallelujah, the more I find you. The more I find you, the more I love you. Hallelujah, God. The more I seek you. Yes, Lord. The more I find you. Yes. The more I find you. Oh, yes. The more I love you, God. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe and feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep. It's more than I can stand. I'm melting, your peace is overwhelming. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe and feel your heartbeat. This love is so deep. It's more than I can stand. I'm melting, your peace is overwhelming me. Hallelujah. And now be seated at your feet. To worship at your feet. I'll stay right here at your feet forever. And I'll be seated at your feet, to worship at your feet. I'll stay right here at your feet forever. I'm not going anywhere, seated at your feet, to worship at your feet. I'll stay right here at your feet forever. And we'll be seated at your feet, to worship at your feet. We'll stay right here at your feet forever. We want to stay right here at your feet forever. We will stay right here at your feet forever. I wanna sit at your feet, drink from the cup in your hand, lay back against you and breathe and feel your heartbeat. Hallelujah. Your love is too deep, Lord. It's more than I can stand. I'm melting, your peace. Hallelujah. It's overwhelming me. Glory to God. Let's give God some glory and praise this morning. We're sitting at his feet. Hallelujah. Glory, God. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Continue to bless God. Oh, my. Thank you, Lord, for that word, that song of worship. And even as she was ministering, I felt a strong sense of rest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Sitting back, oh God. Hallelujah. Laying, oh God. Hallelujah. Casting our cares, oh God. Hallelujah. That's what happens, oh Father, when we worship. Hallelujah. When we worship, we thank God. Hallelujah. For the prayer, we thank God for the song. Hallelujah. And it also reminded me, oh God, draw nigh to God and he will draw nigh to you. We can't help to get close to God when we're close to him. We can't help to build our relationship with God when we're close to him. We can't help it. Hallelujah. In our natural relationships, the more time you spend with somebody, the more you get to know them, for good or for bad. But with our Father, with the one who breathes life into us, hallelujah, you can't help to go deeper in your relationship with him, in our relationship with him, when we are intentional about spending time with him, when we're intentional about drawing close to him, when we're intentional, oh God, about spending, oh God, hallelujah, energy with him. Hallelujah, Father. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Well, again, we greet everyone who has come, who's on the line this morning, those who are watching via Facebook and YouTube. We thank God for each and every one of you. We thank God for those from the KDMI family that are joining us this morning. Hallelujah. I acknowledge and honor right now our apostle, Jimmy C. Thompson. We bring greetings. We thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's celebrate him. Hallelujah. 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 And I am here. I'm not going to hold us up. I'm here to bring the speaker of the hour. Hallelujah to us. Hallelujah. Our very own prophet, Natalie Thompson. Hallelujah. She is one of a kind. She is a college graduate. Okay. She's added a few letters to her name since the last time she spoke. We thank God for it. But even as she has graduated naturally, we thank you for the spiritual graduation that takes place as well. Hallelujah. We just celebrate her this morning and we decree and declare that there are open hearts to receive, that ears are open, Prophet Nat, that you would decrease as Minister Val prayed so that God can be increased and that you will share everything that the Lord has deposited inside of you for this morning. So without further ado, we welcome Prophet Nat to speak this morning, to share what the Lord has.
Glory to God. Glory to God in the highest. I am just so honored today. I am just so humbled today for this opportunity to come before you. As the Lord leads me, we first give honor to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. He is the head of my life. He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. I can't do nothing without God. I'm telling you, he's my front, my back, my side. He is my everything. And I'm so grateful to him for who he is in my life. I honor my apostle, my pastor, Apostle Jimmy C. Thompson Jr. I honor him today, a man of God, a man of wisdom. I honor him today and the position that he holds in Kingdom Deliverance Ministry as he leads us, as he follows Christ. I'm grateful for him on today and each and every one of you. What an amazing prayer on today, even our scripture reading. And I'm telling you, every time I hear the worship that comes forth, it's just always so timely. It's always right on time and just what we need on today, each and every time. I bless God for my amazing church, for my Kingdom Deliverance Ministry family. I honor God that he has placed you with us. No one is just placed anywhere. The scripture says God places, he puts them as it pleases him. So it pleased God to place you in Kingdom Deliverance Ministry. And for that, I am grateful today. I thank and praise God for each and every one that is here under the sound of my voice. As I give you what the Lord has given me on this week, I thank God for our scripture reading on today. We'll be coming out of 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7 and then 10 through 13. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verse 7 and then 10 through 13. And then our last reading will be out of Psalms 133, 1 through 3. Our reading. But the Lord said to Samuel, do not look at his appearance or at the height of his stature, because I have rejected him. For the Lord sees not as man sees. For man looks at the outward appearance, but the Lord looks at the heart. Verse 10 through 13. Again, Jesse made 7 of his sons to pass before Samuel. And Samuel said unto Jesse, the Lord has not chosen these. And Samuel said unto Jesse, are here all of thy children? And he said, there remaineth yet the youngest, and behold, he keepeth the sheep. And Samuel said unto Jesse, send and fetch him, for we will not sit down until he come hither. And he sent and brought him in. Now he was ruddy and withal of a beautiful countenance and goodly to look on. And the Lord said, arise, anoint him, for this is he. Then Samuel took the horn of the oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren. And the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose and went to Ramah. Psalms 133, 1 through 3. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. It is like the precious ointment upon the head that ran down upon the beard, even Aaron's beard, that went down to the skirts of the garment. As the dew of Hermon, and as the dew that descended upon the mountains of Zion. For there the Lord commands the blessing, even life forevermore. If I was to leave a topic or thought with you on today, it would be from alignment to manifestation. From alignment to manifestation. As many of you are aware, I'm grateful for graduating on Mother's Day weekend. Such a grateful opportunity for me. And it was only by the direction of God that I was able to do it and to finish it. I remember when the Lord challenged me and he said, I want you to finish what you started. I wanted to encourage someone today that there is something you started that you need to finish. And until you finish it, until you complete it, there won't be that satisfaction that you really desire to have until you obey and complete the assignment. As you know, I work at a company where I'm a manager, and I didn't need a degree to get the position. But it was something I really wanted to finish. So being a manager, it has come with challenges and opportunities. And one of the challenges that I'm having, or one of the opportunities that I've just been given, is to do evaluations. In the process of the evaluation, the employee has to line up with the job description in order to receive a raise or a promotion. Of course, in that lining up, they have to evaluate themselves, and then I have to evaluate them. And so it brought me to the thought of alignment and how important alignment is when it comes to even the work of God and the kingdom of God. One comment that I gave to each of the ones that are on my staff is that they need to work for where they want to be and not for where they are. most of the time, we will do what it is we need to do in that moment until it's raise time or promotion time. And we look on how somebody else is being promoted or advanced or given something, be it a house, a car, a job, whatever it might be, when we see someone getting blessed. But you don't know the story behind the glory. I began to think about a conference that Apostle and I went to at Bishop Jake's church, and it was called About My Father's Business. And he began to tell the story about a young man that came up for prayer, and he wanted to receive the same anointing and the same thing that Bishop Jake's had on his life. So he began to pray for this young man, and he began to say, let his house burn down and let his children be rebellion and let him lose his job. And he just began to pray all these horrible things over this man's life. And he opened his eyes and the man looked at him and he said, wait, I didn't ask for that. And he said, but that's what I went through to get where I am. We have to be so very careful in looking on and seeing the end of the matter, but not knowing the process in the middle. Oh, it's easy. You might say, oh, I see, I want to graduate. But let me tell you something. It was a sacrifice for me to work full time, to go to school, really full time, because I carried 12 credits at times. And to pastor, and to be a wife, and to be a mother, and a grandmother, and the list goes on. But you don't know the story behind the glory. Yes, it takes something. And I was saying the same thing to the staff. I said, you want the promotion, but you gotta come in alignment. Alignment is so key in this season. It's so key for us to get everything that God has for us, that alignment, you can't get out of it. So as I begin to look at this, God brought me to the story of Samuel and what he had to do. At this particular time, God had rejected Saul. He said Saul was no longer the person for him. So in the process, Samuel was mourning, and God wanted him to get up from there. There is a time and a season for everything. He told him, we got to get the king that's supposed to be in this position. So he proceeded to send Samuel into Bethlehem. Often, we think in order to be picked or chosen, there has to be a certain amount of initials behind our name. Or we have to know somebody that knows somebody. I often talk about my testimony with my job. I wasn't looking for the job, but the job was looking for me. I was already working and I was satisfied where I was. But there was a need somewhere where God had to get me there. And so the search began to find me. There was somebody even in the job that I eventually occupied. And they weren't doing as great a job, I was told. So the process had to start to move that person and to get me in place. You just have to know that when it's your time, it's your time. I only responded to the job because it was close to the house, but didn't realize the need or what was needed at the place where God was going to put me. You don't have to be in the company of the right people to be the right person. I'm going to say that again. You don't have to be in the company of the right people to be the right person. You just got to be in right alignment with the person that sees it all. That's God. As long as you are in alignment with the will and the way of God, there is no good thing, he said in his word, that he will withhold from us. So we see in the scripture that Samuel was given the task of anointing the next king, which was among Jesse's sons. The Lord, as we know, had rejected Saul, and he told Samuel, no longer crying, no longer mourning. When God removes or does what God does, we have to accept what God does. No need in sitting there crying about it. No need in going around trying to figure out why or why did this happen. But we've got to accept it and know that God sees way further, further up the road than we see. So he saw what Saul was going to do, and he removed Saul. So Samuel goes to Bethlehem to meet with Jesse to anoint the next king. The scripture states when Samuel arrived, Jesse brought out who he thought Samuel would want to see, not remembering that David was out in the field. Now you think about this. How would you feel? Everybody's up in the house and you out working, doing what you always done. David never stopped. He never complained and mumbled and grumbled about the fact they were all up in the house and he was still out in the back working. We have to stay focused on the assignment at hand and what it is we are to do. Don't get consumed with what nobody else is doing. It doesn't even matter, because when it's your time, it will be your time. I want to point out that David was, he was not looking to God and asking, all my brothers up in the house and I'm out here working, they should be helping me. He kept working because, see, promotion is a heart matter. It's a heart matter. That's why he said, you're looking at the outward, but I'm searching the heart. We don't see that heart. I can make you believe anything. You know, looking at me in a black dress, you might think I'm a size 10, but when that dress come off, baby, I'm not a size 10. So you're looking at the outward. We can put on all the garments that are needed underneath to make me look like a 10. But when it's all over, I'm not a 10. That's why God got to search that heart. He got to search the heart, and he knows the heart. So despite what you might see here, don't let it fool you. That's why he had to direct Samuel how to pour that oil. Because looking on, the other brothers looked so much better than David. But that wasn't what God wanted. This is a side note. If often you want something so bad, you have to wonder or examine, why do you want it so bad? Why do you want it? You want to be king, but do you know the responsibilities that come with it? You got to count up the cost. I was talking to a person the other day, and I was thinking about a master's. And when, you know, in me thinking about it, because I'm in this school mode right now, I said, I have to count up the cost. I have to pray about it. I have to see if this is the way for me to go. And the person said to me, you have to make sure there's no vain desire behind you wanting to get it. And you have to know if the master's would be the thing for you to do at that time. So after further prayer and even seeking wisdom, seeking counsel or direction from someone that already accomplished it, I said, let me just wait a minute and pray about it and decide if it's somewhere I need to go. You have to examine your reason sometimes when you're desiring something so badly. David didn't desire that. That was what the Lord had promised him. It was what the Lord had appointed and anointed him to do way before he was even conceived. I want to let you know that even the position that Apostle and I are in right now, it was never a sought out position. It wasn't. Often people look at pastors when they get love gifts or things like that, and they think, I want that too. But you just don't know everything that comes along with it. Just because I got a pair of shoes. Baby, let me just buy you a pair of shoes. Don't become a passenger to a pair of shoes. Let me just treat you to a pair of shoes. You want a dress? Let me treat you to one. You ain't got to get a title to get that. I can treat you. Let me help you. Because this right here is no joke. This right here, oh my God. You better know God put you where he put you to do what you got to do. If you're not discerning it for the right reason, it's a heart matter. Samuel tried to pour that oil on all those sons that appeared to be the right ones. This time was so crucial because it was not up to Samuel to make the decision. The oil would not move without God. I want you to know that when God chooses you, there's an oil that comes with that position. There's an oil that comes with that anointing that comes with what God has chosen you to do. You will get the stamina, the energy, the creative ideas, everything that comes along with it, because it's a package deal. When the oil didn't pour the way it was supposed to pour, Samuel knew these were not the ones. And so he asked Jesse, do you have another son? If you look at the scripture, he didn't even describe him in a way that would appear to be appealing to Samuel. He said, yeah, he's out with the sheep. He's a little ruddy guy. That doesn't sound appealing. But Samuel knew he was on assignment. He told him, go get him. Go get him and bring him in here. And David didn't even know what was even going to take place. But when the oil began to pour, he was the answer to the question. Many of you are the answer to the question. But you got to know the right question. All the questions are not for you. Every assignment is not for you. I told someone the other day, they were telling me how someone was reaching out to them about this and that. And I said, you got to pray about that because all of that might not be your assignment. Answer your assignment. Stay in your lane. Do what God has aligned you to do. And it won't be a challenge, a trial, or so heavy on you. It becomes heavy because we operate out of the anointing and the calling that we have been ordained for. You got to operate in your calling and your anointing. When the oil went down, it was David's time. And everybody knew it. When it's your time, everybody will know. Because what God doesn't, he said, what we do in secret, he'll do it. He'll open it up. And show everyone it will be rewarded openly. You don't have to say anything. I didn't have to say nothing about my position. They started, like I said, I wasn't even looking for it because I was okay where I was. You just have to keep working. Keep working and keep your heart right before God. Don't mumble, don't complain. Don't ask how long, don't compare, don't keep crying about it over and over, trying to make something happen that already has happened because God said it would happen. And now you're trying to make it happen by your hands. And all you making is a mess. All you doing is prolonging what God has already said will be. That's what happens when we get in the mix and get in out of alignment from what God has for us. I looked this up because I know nothing about cars, but I had to look it up. It says, in order for a car, for alignment with car, it says, if your wheels are misaligned, your vehicle will experience a dramatic drop in handling capacity. Constantly pulling in one direction, which can greatly inhibit its ability to turn in the right direction and move in a straight line. If tires aren't aligned, you could be damaging your tires and affecting the vehicle's handling characteristics. That is what misalignment will do, because you have to do more work and your inability to move in a straight line will happen. Then you're out of alignment. And when the oil flows, it doesn't hit you. Because Psalms 133 says it comes down. It comes straight down from the head to the beard to the garment, even to the hem. So it doesn't matter your position in the alignment. You're going to get the oil if you're in the right place. So you don't have to worry about, I want to be at the top. I want to be over here. Just stay in place. And when the oil flows, it's going to come down the way it's supposed to. No, it will not go zigzag and chase you. If you notice, when Samuel was there, he said, go get David and bring him here. He didn't go out there looking in the field, looking all over for him. He said, you go get him and bring him here. Because David had to be in a certain place. He had to be in place for Samuel to pour the oil. Stay in place. If you stay in place, the oil's going to find you. Always will. It never fails. It really won't. If it missed you, it's because you moved. Misaligned. If you didn't get no oil, you was out of place. Misaligned. And as I said, you're now having to carry on or act more out of character because you're handling it yourself. Give it to God. Stay in place. Don't move. It's not the time to move. I don't care what's going on right now. It is the enemy's job to make everything look chaotic so that you'll focus on that instead of focusing on what God already told you. He already told you. Let me act. Let me confirm. Why do you keep fleecing it and fleecing it and fleecing it and going back? God, did you say? Did you say? Because it's not happening at the timing that you said, that you think it should. He doesn't give you the time. He just tells you it's going to be. And all you got to do is obey and stay in line. Manifestation cannot take place if you are out of alignment. Have you ever just tried to drive and you're trying to pull that car back in place so that you can go on that straight line? That's what misalignment will cause. I don't know, as they say, when the beat's going to drop, but baby, you need to be in place that when it drops, you can go ahead and go right with it because it's going to drop. I don't know when it's going to drop. Let me tell you something. Apostle been carrying oil in his car. Why? Because when he finds the building, the beat's going to drop and we're going to be ready to anoint it and it's going to go down. But if he had to tell the lady, let me go back to the house and get oil. No, keep the stuff with you. Be ready. Now, I'm not like a real like dancer. You know, whenever we went any place, this is a real sidebar, old bar. But Deacon Pam always had to teach me some steps when we got there. So that when we got there and the beat dropped, I could be ready and I wouldn't embarrass her, okay? So she would teach me the steps and when we got in, I could just jump right in with everybody else. So you got to be in place and right alignment that when it all goes down, it can go down the way it's supposed to. But if you're out of alignment, you ain't got nobody to blame but yourself. Nobody but yourself. Alignment is gonna happen. We are lined up and we are just waiting for the manifestation. I'm riding around. I'm looking at laundromats. I'm looking at markets. I'm looking at everything and anything that looked like an empty building. And God, is this you? God, is this you? I'm waiting because I don't want the oil to pour on the wrong building. I wanted to pour at the place where it's supposed to be. I mean, we done seen some she shacks, some rat shacks, all kinds of shacks that they call a church. But I said, that ain't us. We gonna wait on God. And I'm telling you today, you gotta wait on God. Stay in alignment. And whatever it is that you're supposed to do, don't be so anxious for it. The scripture says, be anxious for nothing. For nothing. For nothing. I'm going to tell you, my mom, whenever we would want to get outside so bad, my mom would say, you want that too bad. You want to get out there too bad. Something's out there. You must gonna get into something. So guess what? You ain't going outside because you want it too bad. And she was right. We wanted to get out there with Christine Dukes, Daniel Dukes, and all our friends on Guilford Avenue to have us a good time. But mama could smell a rat, okay? You got to smell a rat when the enemy is setting you up to get out of alignment. Baby, recognize it and tell him not today and tomorrow ain't looking good either. I won't get out of alignment. I will not curse my destiny going on a fleshly thing. I won't. I'm not going to move. I'm going to stay right here, keep tending to the sheep and knowing that God did not forget me. I'm going to stay here and keep on working, knowing that he who had begun a good work in me shall perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. I'm going to keep working. Don't get out of alignment. We are right at manifestation, but it's not going to happen if you move, and you got to move because God don't change. Whatever he said that he will do, I declare he will do it because he don't lie. He's going to do it. If he said that your child is healed, baby, all I'm doing is looking. I'm just waiting. If he said that job is yours, I'm just looking for the email. I'm just waiting for my letter to say, congratulations, welcome to the team. I'm just looking. He said that car's mine. Okay, it might not be at that dealership, but I'm going to get that car. I thought about Apostle's dad. He wanted a Cadillac. And it was so funny. He went to a place in Baltimore. And when he went there, they wouldn't give him the car because they said it was something with his money or whatever it was, but they wouldn't give it to him. It wasn't even his credit. They wouldn't give it to him. He went all the way to North Carolina. He went down there for a convention, went to another dealership, and guess who drove back up with the Cadillac? His dad, because it was his Cadillac. That just wasn't the dealer, okay? He drove it back up, and guess who did the service on the Cadillac? The car that said, the dealership that said they weren't going to give it to him. So bam, there you go. Now you're going to take care of the Cadillac that I told you to give me from the start. That might not be the dealer, but what God said is what he said. That might not be the realtor to get you the house that you're looking for. Get another realtor, but the house is yours. If that headhunter can't find you a job, baby, ditch him. Sorry, thank you. I'm getting another one. But what God said is for you is for you. You just got to stay in alignment. And alignment is going to bring manifestation every time. Every time. David was the one. Didn't know it because Saul was in there. But when Saul's time was up, David's time, the line started moving. I want you to know the line's moving. It's moving. The line is moving. And you can't get out of alignment in feelings. Feelings will change. You got to align with the word of God and the will of God. And nobody can tell you that. You got to get in that word. I don't know what it is. It's an old saying, but reading really is fundamental. You need to read. Read your word. Read your word. Line it up with what God said. And then work the word. You want to work people, work the word. Come in agreement with the word, because the word works. But you don't want to read. You don't want to put in the times of dedication. You don't want to kill this flesh. Kill it. Because this flesh just wants to have fun. Everything ain't fun all the time. It's not always fun and games. And guess what? For me to get my degree, I had to come in alignment. There was sometimes I couldn't go to the cookout all day long. It was some days I couldn't go to the store or go to the mall or go hang out. I had to pick and choose. If Sunday was my day to have fun, enjoy, and relax, then that meant I had to be focused and dedicated Monday through Saturday. Alignment is sacrifice. You want manifestation. It's going to take some work. And we got to work. Alignment takes work. David kept working until it was his time. And he didn't have to look for Samuel, because Samuel was looking for him. He stayed right where he was supposed to be. And Samuel came and found him. He wasn't even in the house. He wasn't even in the house. But it was his time. Alignment and manifestation go hand in hand. Purpose, when it meets the right timing, it's manifestation. You don't have to worry about it. You don't have to beg for it. You just got to keep believing. Don't give up. Don't faint. This ain't the time to faint. Nor is it the time to question God. Did you forget me? Come on. Why would he forget you? He didn't forget you. But maybe he's working something out of you. He never forgot Joseph. But some stuff had to be worked out of Joseph. That's why he said, no worries. You meant it for evil, but God meant it for good, to bring much people alive. He understood the purpose. He didn't at the time, because I'm sure when the guy said, I ain't gonna forget you when I get out of here. I got you, Joseph. And he forgot when he left the jail. He said, I thought surely I was out of here. But that wasn't the way. Nobody could get the glory but God. Stop asking people for help here, help here, help me there. Let God lead you. And what is for you, I'm telling you, it'll come together. Just like that. I'm grateful to God. Alignment will always bring manifestation. But if you're misaligned, you got to check it. It's a heart matter. Check your heart. You can line up everything here, but it starts from the inside. And once it's aligned on the inside, it'll manifest on the outside. They used to say something on the inside, working on the outside, brought about a change in my life. We used to sing it, shout to it and everything. No time we wasn't changing. It was just a song. But it became a reality when trials and tribulations came. That something had to be working on the inside. Get that heart right. Search your heart. Why do you want it so bad? I want a house. You can't even take care of an apartment. I want a house. Your car dirty. All your shoes, every shoe you own is in the back. If somebody got to get in and you got to say, excuse the mess, you're not ready. You're not ready. Let me clean off that seat. You're not ready. Clean it up. Treat it like you want something more. Work for what you want, not for where you are. Work for what you want. It'll come without a doubt. Because he who is faithful, he's faithful and he never forgets. He started a good work in you and God will finish it. Because he has the finisher's anointing to do exactly what he said. I'm grateful to God that he has the final say. He does. I know sometimes we think it's other people or even our bosses, but God has the final say. Someone asked me on my job, what you gonna do with these people? I said, this ain't my people. They ain't my people. I'm here to do a job. I don't worry about it. But I have to be a light even on that job. No, I don't go in and speak it in tongues, but I'm a light on that job. I heard someone say this. There's a nice heartbeat on this job. That's God. Because that ain't my building. There's somebody there that needs something that I'm supposed to give. And for each one of you on this line, each one of you that will watch, you are placed strategically because there's something you're supposed to give or deposit at that job. At the job, at the church, at that ministry, at the school, wherever you are there placed strategically by the hand of God. And so when you move out of place, you mess up the assignment. You're misaligned. Check your heart, get it together, and keep going, because you're so close to manifestation. If you get out of line, you're gonna have to start over. It's manifestation time for those that are aligned. Stay in alignment. Manifestation time is here. I love you. I bless God for each and every one of you. And the call of God that's on your life is very real. You're destined for greatness. And can't nobody change it but you. Nobody has that much power except you give it to them. Give it to God. Trust God. Because although sometimes we say we trust God, you really find out how much you trust him when the trials and tribulations rise up. And then you have to examine. It's like, why would I act like that? Because you got to check it. Trust is not because I got $10,000 in the bank that I can make my mortgage. Trust comes when you don't have the $10,000, but I can still know I'm going to make that mortgage. 10 grand and my mortgage 1,000, I'm good for 10 months at least. But what about when it runs out? Then you where's your trust then? You gotta be in alignment with the will of God and what he said he will do on your life. It's manifestation time. And God is not slack. He got enough for all of us because we're his children and he loves us. When he died on that cross, it was for all of us. And his grace is sufficient for everything that we need. I love you. I honor God for you today. And I pray today that you understand that you are placed strategically where you are for a reason and a purpose. And that your alignment is not by accident, but it's for manifestation. For those that are in need. I love you. God bless you. And I pray that this word will carry you someplace that you haven't been. God bless you. I turn it back over to Elder Taney.
Amen. 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 Can we bless God for the word? Can we bless God for the word? Can we bless God for our very own prophet, Natalie Thompson? God, I thank God for the way he gives words to Prophet Nat. I thank God for the way humor included in everything. She knows, she breaks it down in a way that is so relatable, and I'm very thankful for that. Yeah, I was over here taking notes. So the Cliff Notes version, finish what you started, from alignment to manifestation, work for where you want to be and not for where you are. And when we are in alignment with God, manifestation is inevitable. It's manifestation time. So the other thing that she said, when she talked about the consequences to misalignment, that we end up doing more work than necessary. And it may look like nothing to us. I'm just going to stay here. I'm just going to cruise it out. You know, I'm not going to rock the boat. I'm not going to take the leap because I'm comfortable. But every decision has the potential to change the course of our lives. If God tells us to do something and we say, not right now, or I don't feel ready. So some of us may be out of alignment in different areas of our lives. And I just pray that today's word stirred our spirits up to repent and return back to what God has for us. To say, God, I'm sorry, forgive me. I wasn't listening. I didn't listen. I was supposed to go right and I went left. I was supposed to go north and I went south. I was supposed to go east and I went west. I didn't listen. I wasn't paying attention, but I'm back and I want everything that you have for me. I want everything that you have for me, and I love you and I won't do it again. Amen, 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 amen. Well, I thank God for the word. I pray that that everything you poured out, Pastor Nat, that it be returned, a greater measure be returned to you. And I thank God that he sees your obedience as well. Well, it's offering time, it's offering time, it's offering time. That's an excellent place to sow, hallelujah, after a word like that. So the Bible says in 2 Corinthians 9 and 7, each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And so as we sow, we keep in mind that we don't do it begrudgingly, we don't do it by force, but we cheerfully give God back what he's already given to us, amen? And so there are several ways that we can give. Cash App, $KDMI, the city. We could give through Givelify, and then of course, traditional ways, cash, check. Please connect with us and let us know how you would like to sow. And so if everybody's ready, we're just going to pray over the offering. God, we thank you for this word. We thank you for today. We thank you, Lord, that you have given us the ability to sow. We know that it's a blessing to be able to give. We thank you, Lord, that you give seed to the sower. Hallelujah. We pray, oh God, that even as we are giving, that you will increase our financial awareness. Hallelujah. That you, oh God, will create, oh God, ways for us to learn more about how to manage our money, that you'll create ways for us to gain streams of income, God. We thank you, Lord, that our intentions are pure in giving, Father. And we thank you, Lord, that everything that we sow, oh God, that you will return it to us, oh God, in a greater measure, Father. And we thank you for all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen, amen, and amen, and amen. And can we bless God for today's service, for the prayer, for the song, for the word? And at this time, I will just like to extend an invitation to our apostle, Jimmy C. Thompson, if he has any words to say to close us out.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Elder Cheney. A great, great word from Prophet Nat today. Great service. And God bless all that's on the line. I just want to decree the blessing of the Lord upon you today, upon us. And I decree it out of Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse number 1, that as we observe to do all that God's commissioned and commanded us to do, may you live, multiply, and go in and possess the land. Everything that God has given and assigned to you, may you possess it all. And I want to decree out of 2 Corinthians chapter 9, following Dr. Cheney's word from the scripture, that God make all grace abound towards you, that you always have all sufficiency in all things, so that you excel in every good work. Have an amazing day in God. We love you. Until we see each other again, God bless you.
Hallelujah! We serve a strong God. He's a mighty God. He is Jehovah Jireh. He is Jehovah Sanctu. He is Jehovah Rapha. He's a great God. And we give him praise. Hallelujah. You are God, and you're in control. Seated high, you are Lord of all. Great I am, sovereign ruler, Lion of Judah. Change.